Hello YouTube and welcome to Heathen Hacks.
Two of the most common questions on computer-related forums is how do I update my BIOS and do I need to update them? And on this video, I will show you how to update it step by step, briefly talk about the latter question, and then we'll update the chipset drivers while we're at it as well. I'm not sure what the procedure is on Intel CPUs though, but I guess it's just about the same. Let's go! Alright, first make sure that you have a spare USB flash drive that you can use. It's also essential to be certain that the USB flash drive is not malfunctioning in any way and only update your BIOS when the weather is okay and when you are absolutely sure that the power or electricity supply would not suddenly be disconnected. Use a UPS if you have to. Because once the BIOS update installation starts and somehow it gets interrupted, depending on the motherboard you have, your board could either have a bad time recovering from it or worse, it could get bricked and not be usable anymore. Unless you yourself knows how to fix it, or you know someone who knows how to fix it, or it's still covered by the warranty and RMA policy. Now that that's done, to check whether you have the latest BIOS version or not without going into the BIOS, first let's download and install CPU-Z. As you can see here, it's currently on version F30A because I just updated mine last August 28, 2020. Now, to check and see if we need to download and install a BIOS update, just Google your motherboard's chipset number and model and then click search. My motherboard is an X570 Aorus Master, so that's the one I entered. And then go to the motherboard's manufacturer website. The manufacturer of both Aorus and Gigabyte products is Gigabyte, so I will click this one. When you're on the product page, click on support, then look for BIOS. So, right here it says that the newest BIOS version is F31J. It was uploaded just last November 20. It also has some stability improvements. So, I definitely need to update my BIOS. Alright, now click on download. After a BIOS update, it's also a good practice to update the chipset drivers as well if it's available. For us to know what chipset version is currently installed, just launch Windows Explorer. Click on Local Disk C. Usually, it's just inside the folder named AMD. Click on Chipset Driver Installer. Based on the Date Modified tab, this is the latest one that was installed last June 6, 2020. And it's version 2.04.28.626. To make sure that it's the correct version, right-click on it and then click on Properties. Then go to Details tab. It says on the file version that it is indeed version 2.04 or 2.4.28.626. Now, to check whether we can update it or not, let's go to the AMD website. Just launch a web browser, search for AMD, then click on driver and support. Scroll down a little, click on chipsets, socket AM4 because that's the socket of my CPU, then choose the chipset of your motherboard, then click on submit. Now, click on the plus icon. It says here that the latest version is 2.10.13.408 and it was released last October 19, 2020. Let's check out the driver details. There it is. 3rd Gen AMD Ryzen Desktop Processor. I have the 3900X by the way. Then AMD X570 chipset. Package includes AMD chipset drivers and AMD Ryzen power plans. Alright, now click on download. After downloading, get your USB flash drive. Mine is this one. Conveniently labeled as BIOS. Connect it to your PC. And then format it according to what file system your motherboard requires it to be. In my case, according to my motherboard's manual, it should be FAT32. So I formatted it to FAT32. Cut the BIOS zip file, paste it into your BIOS flash drive, and then extract it. Delete the zipped file, and after that, let's head to the BIOS. Now, you can either go there using fastboot if your motherboard supports it, or just by using the delete key. Depending on how you want to proceed, you could also save or copy your overclock settings first before updating your BIOS. You could either take pictures of your settings or if your motherboard supports it, you can even save screenshots of it to a different USB flash drive and then transfer them to your phone. For this one, I'm going to use my other flash drive. Connect it to the computer and then just click on F12 to take and save the screenshots. Okay, so now that we're done taking screenshots and have transferred them to our phone, we can finally proceed on updating the BIOS. Just gotta plug it in like that. Reboot the computer and then press the delete key repeatedly. Alright, now that we're inside the BIOS, click on F8 or Q-Flash. Then click on BIOS Update. There's our USB flash drive. As you can see here, the updated version is 31J, and the version that is currently installed is F30A. Okay, click on Next. Are you sure you want to update BIOS? Click on Yes. Wait for it to verify, then press Start. After updating the BIOS, the motherboard would make a few reboot cycles. No need to be alarmed, it's normal. Now that we have successfully booted into Windows, let's make sure that we have actually updated the BIOS. Let's launch CPU-Z again, click on Mainboard, there it is. Then, head back to BIOS and set up the OC. After setting up the OC, let's move on to the AMD chipset drivers. Again, this depends on how you want to proceed with the installation. You can update it even if there are previously installed AMD chipset drivers, but for me, I feel better when I do a clean install. So that's just what I'm going to do. Now let's install the AMD chipset drivers. Just right click on it and then click on Run as Administrator. Here are the stuff that are going to be installed. Alright, click on Install. Then restart to finish. After restarting, let's check on our power plan settings to make sure that the high performance is still selected. There it is. Then check on the drivers folder. There you go. And we're done. Now, the answer to the question, do I need to update my BIOS? Is, it depends. If the BIOS update is an answer or a way to fix bugs or compatibility issues with your motherboard, then yes, you should definitely update. However, if the update has nothing to fix or has nothing to add or to optimize, then as most programmers would say, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. That's it, really. Thanks for watching and see you again next week. Maybe.